So this is it. This is where the magic happens. You know what a terrific cook I am. And you know that this must be the center of my house. And this is it. This is the place where I come through the door. This is the place where I set down the carryout and I say, hey, dinner's ready. This is the place where the magic happens. Welcome to the season of Lent, where you and I together go on a journey where we're reminded of our daily bread and where our daily bread comes from. During the season of Lent, for the whole 40 days, I would like for you to take a mug or a bowl or a plate or maybe even a glass out of the back of your cabinet, maybe one that you don't use very much, maybe one that's decorative, and I would like for you to set that somewhere as a reminder. You see, the season of Lent is a season to practice. It's also a season to simplify. It's a season where what is normally so complicated and complex is meant to be focused, and we're meant to hear God in the ordinary. So the idea that I've taken here is that we take a mug. This is a mug that Ryan made at a pottery place about 10 years ago. And so I would take a mug, something like this, and I would like for you and I to replicate, to do in our lives what monks many, many, many years ago used to do, mendicant monks. They used to go out with a begging bowl, and they would ask for alms, and whatever they got that morning would be what they took with them to get through the rest of the day. That was all that they owned, that was all that they had, was a begging bowl, and they depended on people to fill it. This is Lent in plain sight, and so I would like for you to set a reminder for yourself that we're in the season of Lent, and I would like for it to be a begging bowl. The idea of our begging bowl is that it connects us to other people. It helps us be connected to others where we're dependent upon them and we're asking for help or helping them. There's a really simplified connection with people there. It also reminds us that our daily bread is a gift from God. It reminds us that often we have very complex, very layered, sometimes way more things than we ever need. And so the season of Lent is a time to do our best by the Holy Spirit to pare back and to allow God to speak to us in the ordinary. So during the season of Lent, I would like for you to get your own begging bowl and set it in a place where you come out and go in and out. And I would like for it to be a reminder to you. When you see it, I would like for you to just pray simple words. Simple words about being provided your daily bread, that God may give to you this day your daily bread. Pray about connection and connecting with others. Pray about God's taking care of you today. Just take it one day at a time and use this as a reminder for a little prayer as you go in and out your door. Okay? So for the season of Lent in plain sight, I'd like for you to have a begging bowl and to put it in a place that reminds you to say that prayer. The season of Lent begins with Ash Wednesday. Now, we can use our begging bowls not only as a reminder throughout all these 40 days, but also to help us practice on Ash Wednesday, to kick this off. We know that on Ash Wednesday, as Lutherans, part of the service has to do with our physical movement, our physical bodies. We know that the pastor normally will wipe that ash on our foreheads, and it's trying to speak to who we are in our souls. And it says, remember that you are dust, and to dust you shall return. This is a great simplifying and hopefulness that God can speak to us in ordinary life. But we also know that we're in a much different time, and that Ash Wednesday will more than likely be different this year than it's been. So for the next few days, I would invite you to take your begging bowl, and throughout the season of Lent, when these begging bowls, I'm going to ask you to use them in different ways. But the first way for Ash Wednesday is to go out to your yard. And yeah, I know they're covered with that gross white stuff at this point. But if you can, to get down to where there's some dirt in your yard and place that in your begging bowl. Or you could use a plant inside your home and you can take some of the dirt out of there. Maybe you're a person with a fireplace and you can use that and put some ash in your begging bowl. Not only will this be a reminder as you go in and out for the next few days, it could also be the place where, using some dirt, you can safely in your own home make the sign of the cross on each other's foreheads or on your own forehead. You can use dirt from your yard or dirt from a plant. You can use ash from a fireplace. Really, whatever you use, just something that connects you to creation and reminds you that it isn't you and I who are in control, but God who is. And you can set that here. You can use your begging bowl for the dirt. In the next few days, we'll wash that out. And in the coming weeks, we'll use that for other things. This is Lent in plain sight. And I've invited you into my home to see where the magic happens. This is where the daily bread seems to often is set down when I get home. This is where I go in and out. This is where it will begin with Ash Wednesday. And this is the reminder to practice and to invite the Spirit into my life in just a 5-second prayer every day as I go out and as I come in. And my hope would be that you do indeed hear it and know it, that this is a season where our senses are heightened, where the gifts that God has given us, these ordinary things, are all that we need to be connected to one another and for the Spirit to move and for us to be filled with God's presence and hope. This is Lent in Plain Sight. Stay safe.